Hey everyone, my name is Jenny and we're going to be doing some visual art today as we are still among Atmospheradelphians. We are going to be talking about the weather. And Lindsay already made a great forecast for us for this week, if you want to check out her video. But today what we are going to do is focus on shape and color of the weather. So we're going to be making some paintings of the weather. We are going to be making watercolor paintings of the weather, but what shapes and colors do you think make up our weather? Then, like with clouds, we picture really organic shapes. That means they're very curvy shapes. We've talked about tornadoes a lot. There's been some problems with gremlins and tornadoes lately in Atmospheradelphia, and we're still working on it. So when we think of tornadoes, we think of how they're that spiral, so they're really twisty, really swirly. What would a hurricane look like compared to a twister? What kind of shapes do you think that would be? Maybe the shapes that wind would make. What would wind look like? All those winds that are sweeping everything up. Now is a good time. Maybe we should assign colors to some of these. So when you think of tornado, I think of like maybe purple, or like maybe some green in there too. So as we think of these shapes and colors, we should also think of what happens when they meet. So what happens when the colors and the shapes of a thunderstorm come in to the straight rays of sunshine that are yellow? Maybe they're yellow? What does it look like when those colors blend together and those shapes mix together? That's what we're gonna explore today. So what are you gonna need for this? Oh, I'm glad you asked. You will need paper. It can be whatever color you want. I've used white and I've used blue. And you will need crayons. And you will need a little paint set. I'm using watercolors. You're gonna need a good place to paint. So make sure it's okay with your adult person if you are painting somewhere and you might get a little messy. And last but not least, you'll need some water and some paint brushes. And then we can get started. Pause here to collect your supplies. You'll need one piece of paper, crayons, a watercolor set with a brush, and a cup of water. Unpredictable. So what I'm gonna do is start with my crayons, and I'm gonna start with a little bit of sunshine. So I'm gonna start with orange. And my favorite thing about crayons and watercolor is that since the crayons are waxy, then I can do this with crayon and make my little circle for like my sun, and then come back in with watercolor and paint over it, and I can still see my crayon. And then with my clouds, I used a white crayon, and then it kind of shows up even more when I paint over it. So remember that while we're working. I started, I have my sun and I wanted it to be like sun radiating out, so I did these curved lines, and then the sunshine, the rays are really stretching out. Maybe they will be trying to battle a hurricane, or maybe they'll be battling rain, and then there's like a rainbow at the end. I like that idea. Maybe I'll do that. Then I can get a lot of shape and color if I do a hurricane and a rainbow. Let's try that. So this is the start of my hurricane. Let me see it. The start of my hurricane, it felt like it was a lot of swirls, but also not the same swirls as a cloud and not the same swirls as a tornado. So this is what I came up with. And now I wonder what it'll look like when these two meet. Like, what do these two look like when they're mixing? And I did all these swirls, but you can't really see them. But when I do watercolor over them, they're gonna appear. So it's like it's invisible. This is my hurricane. I tried to do some swirls that were like all over the place, really moving around. So they're not like tiny little swirls. They're some big ones that are really covering up a bunch of the sky. Then I think when the hurricane and sunshine meet, I'll figure that out when I'm painting, see if I can blend colors. Okay. And I said I was gonna do a rainbow. I did all my crayon and I decided my rainbow was gonna come close to my sun and to my hurricane. I want to see what it can look like when I start painting and see what it looks like when a hurricane and a rainbow and sun all meet together. I'm gonna get my brush wet. It's orange in there. And even when I'm painting, I'm gonna keep my straight lines for my sun, like I said. And they're radiating out, really stretching far out there. The straight lines are gonna be those curvy lines. So I started. Oh, I'm liking this. I'm liking this. We're getting somewhere. We're going. There may be some places where you have to be a little patient because things have to dry. But you can always work on like another area of your paper while you're going. Yellow and orange as my sun, and then when they touch the rainbow, which is they're going to be touching purple right here, so I'm going to have to blend purple and yellow. I wonder what happens when I blend purple and yellow. What color do you think I'll get? Doing my hurricane. I'm gonna keep doing the swirly thing. I wonder if I can swirl while it's painted up. This is new. I'm choosing purple as a hurricane because I've never seen a hurricane. So I'm gonna say they're purple. I have to lay this down to actually paint it. I'll show you as I go. I'm doing those really loose swirls. Because a hurricane isn't as swirly as a tornado, I think. Now I can see the white crayon that I was using. And that's showing up water with my black paint, then it'll come out kind of gray. I want some gray in there, so I used a gray crayon. Okay. So I'm gonna do the purple of my rainbow. And I made my rainbow also an arc, like my sun, because it's radiating out all that color, so it's like ooh. So I started doing the blue for my rainbow, and I started touching the hurricane that I made that I couldn't even see because I did white crayon. And now I can blend them even more together. I don't think I can blend them when they're up like this, but I'll blend them. Okay, so now I want to blend, I want this yellow to touch this purple, so I'm gonna kind of overlap them. Because I want to explore what happens when these colors interact, and I want to see the straight line go through these curvy lines of my rainbow, and just explore what happens there. I made a mistake, but I'm gonna keep going with it. I won't even tell you what the mistake is. You probably won't even see it. I'm gonna just blend some stuff together and keep going. Oh yeah, so I took my sun rays and I made them even longer because I thought, can't even stop this sunshine. It's going even through a rainbow. And probably when this dries, I'll do some crayon over it so that I can really emphasize it. Okay, now I'm gonna blend. I think I'm gonna blend some more hurricane in. I like this. I'm surprised every time I do this. So what we did was really focus on the shape and the color. So I used these curved lines to make my sun and these straight lines to make the rays of the sun. And I kept them all in kind of the same color family. Kept them all orange and yellows. And then I did my rainbow and I just made it arched. So we have these curved lines again. And then this is my hurricane that has all these squiggly lines that go everywhere, and they're making some chaos. And then I get these fun moments where I get to see, like when yellow touches blue, it makes green. So I get to see all those fun moments. We are learning so much this week. It is fantastic. Make sure you let your painting dry. Very important. We don't want to lose any artwork. And then also make sure you clean everything up. Got to start with a clean workspace and end with a clean workspace. Okay. Okay, I'm gonna sparkle myself. I would love to see photos of the drawings everyone creates. Sparkles to you. I'll see you next time. Thank you so much for joining me.